Warm welcome to all. I'm Malavika Pradeep of Class 10A. Today, I'm here to speak a few words on Quit India Movement.
The Quit India Movement, or the Revolt of 1942, or August Revolution of 1942, was the most popular and powerful mass movement in the series of agitations led by Gandhi in the course of freedom struggle. By the time this mass movement was planned, the Second World War was going on. The shadows of the Japanese invasion on India were making the sky dark and cloudy. The efforts of Cripps Mission bore no fruit, and the prices of essential commodities were soaring high, and the day does not appear to be far off for the deliverance from the British imperialism. The summer of 1942 found Gandhi in a strange and uniquely militant mood. "Leave India to God or to anarchy," he repeatedly urged the British. This orderly, disciplined anarchy should go, and if as a result there is complete lawlessness, I would risk it. These statements made in May 1942 are indicative of the restlessness of the leader who promised Swaraj within 1 year and who is eager and anxious to see that his mission of gaining freedom for India is realized soon. Though the need for non-violence was always reiterated, Gandhi's mantra of do or die represents the militant mode of Gandhi. Thank you.
Thank you, Malavika. In the working committee meeting held at Wardha on 14 July 1942, the Congress first accepted the idea of a struggle. The All India Congress Committee that met in Bombay in August ratified this decision to go in for a struggle.
In his speech, Gandhi made it very clear, "I'm not going to be satisfied with anything short of complete freedom." Maybe he will propose the abolition of salt tax, the drink evil, but I'll say nothing less than freedom. Gandhi then followed up with the now famous exhortation, "Do or die." Here is a mantra, a short one that I give you. You may imprint it on your hearts and let every breath of yours give expression to it. The mantra is "Do or die." We shall either free India or die in the attempt. We shall not live to see the perpetuation of slavery. Gandhi also gave a call to all sections of the people, the princes, the jagirdars, the zamindars, the property and money classes, who derived their wealth and property from the workers in the fields and factories and elsewhere, to whom eventually power and authority belong. In the view of the Sumit Sarkar, the above statement of Gandhi indicates his social radicalism and shift in the philosophy of the Congress. By now, people with the goals of socialism and communism have become a part of the broad-based Congress organization. On the other hand, the British too were equally determined to crush any movement of the Congress.
Good morning. My name is Isha and I'm from Class Plus 2B. Today, I'm going to say about some of the incidents and effects that happened during Quit India Movement. The Quit India Movement, or the August Movement, was a movement launched at the Bombay session of All India Congress Committee by Mahatma Gandhi on August 1942. Now, the main immediate cause for the movement was collapse of Cripps Mission, and there were many incidents that occurred in many states. One of the incidents occurred in Tamil Nadu. They are as follows. At every railway station, the policemen waited with a list of local leaders and arrested them when they got down. K. Kamaraj attended All India Congress Committee in Bombay and returned to spread material propaganda, but was arrested and was under detention for 3 years. There were many instances of violence, such as setting fire to post offices in Vellore and Parappakkam. Congress volunteers clashed with the military in Madurai. There were police firings at Rajpakkam, Karaikuri and Devakottai. Now, these were some of the incidents that occurred in the Quit India Movement. In the short term, the Quit India Movement had deleterious as well as beneficial effect. On the positive side, it demonstrated nationalist feeling among people. The movement made it clear that the British would no longer be able to rule India against the wishes of Indians. The movement strengthened the Congress Socialist Party due to its important role in the sustenance of the movement. And on the negative side, people were shot, lathi charged, villages burned and enormous firings imposed. Over 1 lakh people were arrested. INC was banned, Gandhiji was arrested and was released on health grounds in 1944. However, after quitting the movement, the British government realized that they could no longer keep Indians under their control. India's walk down the long road to freedom had entered its final chapter. India gained freedom on August 15, 1947.